Hey, thanks for having us. And it's a real surprise that the guys here are freaking out. I mean, in such a positive way. It's increasing from one Slovakian game to the other. Maybe on Sunday we are completely sold out. And I love this working together. You know, the energy of what's going on in the match is multiplicated out there on the stands. And that makes it unique over there.
The people react to the beat in a very positive way. But I guess there are not only volleyball fans on the stands. I guess there are also many people who just enjoy the atmosphere. And that's the goal, actually, we wanted to reach. Actually, I'm surprised, and it extended my expectations. I can say that, yeah.
And there is one thing, we have never seen such a light show there. It's the very first time we have these kinetic balls, and in my opinion, they look amazing because they're not only an entertainment tool, that's volleyball. You know, that's what the game is all about, is displayed over there. So it's all coming together to create something really new and yeah. I have goosebumps during set breaks at the Slovakian games when all the people enjoy that. I was a player and I guess I react like a player. I can't stand still, I can't sit on my chair. It's like I want to jump to the field of play and got some good rallies there. So it's something you're deeply connected.
If there is a spectacular spike or a huge block, yeah, and you play this jingle and the people first they will just be loud and spend applause, but when they hear the beat, they will do the move, yeah, and you cannot beat that. There are not many sports in the world, actually I cannot see another sport where we can run this style of entertainment.
Ooh, that's difficult because it's so different. Yeah. Like I told you before, in Rio, for example, the most freaking out is if 12,000 people at Copacabana during the night sessions stand and dance samba. You can't do that in the United States or here. So it's very unique. But here, for example, if the people do the monster block with this block, for example, and then they turn to the Slovakian flag and everyone shows, hey, I'm there to support my team. That's also unique. And that's the moments you only can stand there and say thanks to everyone who makes it possible.
For me, it's there's one thing I don't like. There are fans that are really used to whistling and booing, especially when the opponent team is on serve, yeah? And that's something I don't really like because that's disrespectful, but this never happened here. It's a very fair audience and that's very positive. But of course, in some countries that might happen, that there is a lot of whistling and booing, but I think they know it, so I don't have to tell you the countries.
I was at the castle. I went there with the scooter because you have a nice overview there, and it's my first time in Bratislava, so for me the first thing is to get an overview, and I mean that's a special place over there, so it was perfect. And tomorrow at our day off, I'll experience more of that. That was what I promised myself being there the first time.
I'm from Vienna, so actually we are actually neighbor cities, so it's definitely not my first time in Bratislava. I know Bratislava, and I've been to a lot of clubs and bars in the last years, but I didn't do that this time because I wanted to stay focused on the European World Championships. Yeah.